Yep, we're back here again. My name is JT, and welcome to the late night episode of the podcast. You're now sitting here with your boy. You got your Starbucks coffee, got your donut, got your cupcake. Then we are going to sit here and have a good time. By the way, thank you so much for listening to me right now. It's feels really good, like I said, to get on the microphone and know that you're there always waiting for me. It's really cool. And if this is your first time listening to my podcast, this is the late night log episode. This is basically an episode where I do two episodes a day of a podcast, two episodes every day. And the first episode comes out at 1 p.m. Pacific time, and it's basically about me talking about current events that's going on in the news, giving me my opinions about stuff that's going on. Then I do another episode that comes out at 9 p.m. or 7:30 Pacific time, just depends on how I feel at the moment. And that episode, what I do is I spend the time talking about, you know, just talk about what's going on with my life and kind of like things that I've been thinking about lately. It's kind of like my mental release, like my mental, kind of like my mental release of who I am as a person. So you're gonna hear a lot of stuff on this podcast. So just to tell you what's been going on with me lately. I was actually online. I spent the whole weekend watching two shows. I was watching reruns of Luke Cage. And I was also watching this one show on Netflix that I highly recommend you go see. It's called Stranger Things. You might have heard of it already. It's a fairly popular show. Fairly popular. I'm telling you right now, if you ever have the chance to pop you a bag of popcorn and sit in front of your laptop and watch this show, please do. This is one of the best. It's been a long time since I saw a very, very excellently well-produced science fiction program. And Stranger Things is one of them. In fact, I'm thinking about doing a video reviewing Stranger Things and reviewing why did I like it. It was a very, very good program. I thought it was really great. One thing I liked about Stranger Things was I liked the plot. The plot was unique in and of itself. The plot was very unique. I liked the setting. The show was set in like the, I don't know if it was like, I think the 1980s, 1970s. I think it was 1970s. And in retrospect, at first I was kind of like, why would they set it at that time? But it actually was the perfect time. It actually was the perfect time and the perfect setting to have a show based about science fiction, based on like that other world, alternate reality, universe, science fiction type of thing. So it's really cool. It's kind of like, if I could describe it in any word, it's kind of like E.T. It's like E.T. meets, that's a bad term. It's a bad comparison. I'm trying to think of a better one. I don't know. All I know is it's a very good show. I really liked it. I thought it was very, very interesting. One of the people who I really liked in the show was like, you know, the three kids they had in the show, which matter of fact, I'm going to Google them right now. One of them was this, let's see if I can find the cast. I'm Googling the cast right now. I know I should have had this prepared already, but like I said, this episode is more for me to relax, put my hair down, and just talk to you about how I feel about certain things, what's going on in my life. But, very, 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 very good show. Let me see if I can get that. Stranger Things. And I love Netflix, by the way. Shout out to Netflix, man. Netflix is the bomb diggity boom bomb. Okay, here we go. So, oh, by the way, the star, the person who they used to try to put as the star person in it was this woman named Winona Ryder, who was actually a really talented actress. I've seen her in some other programs, Winona Ryder, and she usually does a good job, but this is the first time I saw her in one where I feel like it let her character shine. She is a very, 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 very good actress. She did a really good job in this show. Matter of fact, let me give a round of applause for her. She was a really, 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 really good actress. really, really great actress. She played the part of the mother, and she was doing, and she's 44 years old. Oh, she was beautiful. She's beautiful. They're doing a great job. Did a great job. But I think I saw her in one other movie called Iceman. Let's see if I can find her. Let's see if I can find her. Iceman. I'll just find her. Oh, well. But she, my favorite character in the movie was, she did a, really, everybody in the show was good. Everybody in the show was good. Shout out to Millie Bobby Brown. She did a really great job as 11. Shout out to Gatan Matarazzo. Shout out to Natalia Dyer. Shout out to Finn Wolfhard. Shout out to Charlie Heaton and David Harbour. Shout out to Caleb McCullen. Caleb McCullen. Shout out to him. Did really great. Did really good job. Shout out to all of them. They did really, really great job. Matter of fact, one of them, Charlie Heaton. Have you ever heard of Charlie Heaton? Because I feel like I've seen him. I'm Googling him right now. I'm trying to feel like I've seen him in some other stuff. I can't think of what, though. Actor and musician. So, I'm looking right now because I could have swore I saw him in something. Nope. He's only played on BBC's shows and Netflix shows. He's only just been a that and a musician. So yeah, he was a good actor. He conveyed his job very well. He did his job very well, and even David Harbour. You know, one thing I like about Netflix too is they give a lot of chances to people who aren't really that known in the acting world, at least by mainstream audiences. That's one thing I do like about them. They give that opportunity to a lot of people, and I've always respected that about them. So yeah, it was a really great show. So another show just came on movie. I'm looking at A Walk Among the Tombstones. I've never heard of that before. Walk Among the Tombstones. You know what? Actually, I'm thinking about Walk Among the Tombstones with Liam Neeson. You know, I'm actually thinking about what's that in my head? I'm thinking about going to the theaters on Thursday to go see that movie with Kevin Hart, What Now? And I'm thinking about asking out this girl who works at the Walgreens up the street from my house. I haven't asked her yet. It ain't that I'm nervous. It's just that, I don't know. I think she's kind of cute. I think she's really cool. It's just that, you know, most situations when you ask a girl out, you know, I feel like you shouldn't ask a girl out unless you have a proper, calm place where you can take her to after going out with her. You know, somewhere you can take her to where you can build intimacy with her, you know, and my grandma's couch is not a good place for that. And maybe just because I don't think that would work out pretty well. But at the same time, I also got to be optimistic about it and say, you know, maybe she might see something in me. Maybe she might see something in me that I don't see in myself. Maybe she will see the vision that I possess in the world. Maybe she will see that I am the newborn king. Yeah. Okay, so. You know, I've actually been thinking about sending like a copy of myself singing Disney musicals. So how can you, sir? You must look at your life. Look at your life through heaven's eyes. I'm actually thinking about supplying and sending myself out to be like a Disney musical singer. Like, there's this one musical artist, Brian Stokes Michael, and he sung this song on the Moon movie. You remember that one movie, Prince of Egypt? Ah, I understand. So, there's this one. He sung this one song by. You must look at your life. I can't remember what it's called. You must look at your life through heaven's eyes. You must look at your life. Look at your life through heaven's eye. You must look at your life. Let me Google it right now. I'm going to find it. Because I want you to hear it. I think it's a really great song. I was thinking about it. I just thought about it. You must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join. You must learn to join. You must learn. Oh, Sam. Okay, we got it. I found it. Okay, hold on. Let me see. Let me turn the music off. Turn the music off. Hold on. Turn it off. Hold on. Yeah. Okay. Let me see. I've never heard him sing this song live. So let me see what it was like. It's a very beautiful song, man. Now, I'm going to tell you something right now. I'm watching this video. So right now, it's set in a theater somewhere in... It's set in a theater, and I'm guessing somewhere in New York. And you see a bunch of... You see a bunch of... The orchestra is all white people. The choir is all white people. Let me tell you something. If that had been a black or Brazilian audience, and as soon as they would have hopped in that, yeah, trust me, you would have saw a lot more dance. And that's the only thing I'm critical about. But let's continue. I like this, actually. And one thing I like about this song is Stephen Quartz, shout out to Stephen Schwartz, who So the funny thing about it is he's kind of swaying a little bit in the song to try to give people to get more amped up, move around, but it's like man, he's a shout out to Brian Stokes Mitchell. Let me put the regular music back on. Shout out to Brian Stokes Mitchell, man. Let me give a round of applause to Brian Stokes Mitchell, man. Brian Stokes Mitchell is. Brian Stokes Mitchell is one of the most talented musicians I've ever, most talented vocalists. I mean, one thing, you know, one person quoted was, I like that he's enjoying himself so much. Shout out to that. I like that too. Like, I like that he's singing this song and you just see happiness in his face. Like, that's what I feel about podcasting sometimes is I feel like, I like that I'm doing something that makes me feel happy. I like that I'm doing something that makes me feel great. And this insecurity I've been going through these last couple of weeks, to be honest with you, is I've been going through insecurity where I've been wondering, like, is all my life all that I want to do is podcasting? And I don't think it's that. I think I want to do a lot of stuff. You know, I have an artistic side, because I told you before, I'm a songwriter. And I do like to sing. It's just, I don't know if I can sing all that good, you know. But now I'm starting to learn also that, you know, and maybe you can relate to this too, is I'm starting to learn that maybe it's not so much that I can't sing, more than I'm singing in a tone that my voice isn't really that designed for, naturally. Like, for example, I'll give you a prime example.
I can talk like this. I can talk like this. But this is not my natural way of talking.
But I can talk like this, and words come up more fluid, and words come up more understandable when I'm talking like this, because this is my natural speaking tone. So I've been wondering about, like, maybe when I'm singing, maybe I'm singing songs that maybe I'm singing in the wrong tone. If that makes sense, does that make sense? Like, maybe I'm singing in the wrong tone. Or maybe I'm singing in a tone that's not that regular to me. Because when all you have is nothing, there's a lot to go around. There's a lot to go around. And though you mustn't learn all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. 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 I'm sorry. I know this is a podcast. I know this is me, you guys, talking. I got to play this song. I got to play that part again. Just one more. Hold on. My boy was. And though you mustn't learn. Man, that's some quality singing. That is some quality singing. That shit got me inspired. The hard part about having a voice like mine, I'm gonna tell you right now, is because my music go. Okay. See, the hard part about having a deep voice is it's hard to find somebody to kind of gauge who sounds like you, but who don't sound like you. You know, like, that dude is a talented singer, man. He's very, man, that, Man, I was amazed. Like, you must look at your life. 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 Look at your life through heaven's eye. Look at your life through heaven's eye. See if you can find an interview. I want to hear how he talks. Hold on. The guy's name is Brian Stokes Mitchell. I'll repeat, Brian Stokes Mitchell. He's actually pretty cool. See if I can go back to his interview that he did and see what he's talking about here.
Here we are with The Column, and this week we're interviewing a Broadway titan, a Tony Award winner, Mr. Brian Stokes Mitchell, which we call him Stokes.
Friend. You
want to
be my friend?
I'll be his friend. I'll call him Stokes.
People are not making the livings that people think, you know. It's there are struggling artists. There are
actor Brian Stokes Mitchell among the Broadway.
And though you mustn't learn all the steps, and though you mustn't learn. And though you mustn't learn all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. So yeah, that might be my next feature. You know what? I might be a baritone singer. That might be the next feature I have. Because as though you listened, You know what? For now on, that's my response to any situation that happens. If somebody says something to me, I'm going to say, you must learn to join the dance. If you listen to this podcast and you listen to me later on today, tweet me and be like, you must learn to join the dance. La 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 la. And though you mustn't learn all the steps, you must learn to join the dance. Basic man, but more of the story is, I guess that's that part he's been kind of worrying. Because, you see, I'm those people who I need a sense of artistic expression when I do stuff. And like with podcasting, the thing about podcasting is I love it more than anything else in the world. But at the same time, I always want to have a piece of myself where I'm expressing myself as an artist in some way. And the thing that kind of gets me sometimes is, you know, like I'm a songwriter too, but the thing about it is when I sing, I don't know, you know how I be sometimes, you know, you kind of go through phases where you think you can do something, then you can't do something. I'm going to say, auntie, I'm texting my aunt right now. The video. You must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. That shit is amazing, man. You know, when I looked him up on Wikipedia, because I had looked up Brian Stokes Mitchell on Wikipedia after I heard the song on the Prince of Egypt album, I didn't know... It said he is a powerful baritone, but I didn't know how powerful that was. Man, that was great. But anyway, yes, I'm always going through kind of like these phases where I don't know where I want to be as an artist. I don't know. It's interesting. It's kind of the evolutionary phase of JT. Evolution of JT. So it's kind of interesting. I don't know, but yeah, that's just about been my experience in life lately. That's pretty what I've been up to. Trying to think what else happened this week. Oh yeah, I actually got a sore throat right now. I don't know what that's about. I don't know if I got sick. I don't know if something happened to me lately, but got a sore throat. Don't know what that's about. Just feel like somebody put something in my throat. But anyway, Yeah, man, I'm thinking about going to see Kevin Hart's What Now on Thursday. Now, granted, I'm going to tell you right... Oh, my God! Oh, my God! It's so Okay, right now while I'm reading this podcast, I'm watching, I was watching this video go down on my timeline. It was a chinchilla, and it's like a little tiny wine glass. It is so adorable. So I don't know how. And though you mustn't love. So yeah, what was I gonna say? Yeah, shout out to everybody who's been messing with your boy. I'm probably gonna go see it. Now granted, I don't know how long. Okay, so shout out to every. So I don't know. When I see it, I'm not sure of the quality of the film. I don't think it's going to be that good of a movie. I'm going to be honest with you. But at the same time, I want to support my boy. I do love Kevin Hart. I've been a fan of Kevin Hart for a long time. And I do want to support my boy. I do want to go out there and support. I'm going to start talking like I'm singing for the rest of this podcast. I want to do go out there and support my boy and show him the love that needs to be said. And show him the love that needs to be said. You must look at your life. You must look at your life. Kevin Hart, I want to go there and show you the love that needs to be showed. What now might be a trash comedy film, but I'm still going to go see it and watch what happens in the film. And if I don't like it and I detest, I will not digress. Very, very great film. So, you know, we'll see what happens, man. I have a lot of hopes for it. I still recommend to you to go see that one movie, Birth of a Nation. That is a great movie. I recommend to anybody in the world to go see that movie. That movie is worth the way, way past worth the time and effort. That movie is a very, very excellent movie. I recommend to anybody to go see that movie. It's very, very great. One of them, I'm trying to think, there's some other movie I wanted to go see this week. Thinking about seeing Storks. If you've seen Storks yet, let me know how that movie was. I feel like that movie probably was a great movie, and I haven't gotten to it. I might just go to the theater on Thursday and just spend a whole day in the theater. If I work hard enough, President Obama is actually in Greensboro speaking right now. But, what was I going to say? I had it in my head. If I work hard enough on Wednesday, I might just go on Thursday and just spend the whole. Hold on, what's this? Somebody just tweeted me right now. Shout out to Kyle K. They just tweeted me and said, they said, I don't know. I'm trying to see what they said. Missed it again. God dang it! I need a real phone. I'm tired of this dang old iPhone 4. Everything I do with this iPhone. Everything I do with this iPhone. Everything I do. You must look at your life. You must look at your life. Look at your life. And one thing I love about the world is there's an audience for everything. You must look at your life. What the heck? Okay, so shout out to Kylan_K. He gonna tell me. He hasn't seen the Power Rangers trailer and doesn't have any interest in doing so, honestly. Really? So what happened was I tweeted him. He said, seriously though, that Planet Earth trailer is one of the best I've ever seen. Imagery is just absolutely breathtaking, and it's a trailer. I said, that trailer or the Power Rangers trailer, which one wins? JT, he said, haven't seen the Power Rangers trailer and don't have any interest in doing so, honestly. Bro, are you serious, man? The Power Rangers, man. I haven't actually finished watching the whole Power Rangers trailer, so I'm not in a good position to criticize. But I'm actually going to go see that, too. You know, one thing I like about the Power Rangers, the whole franchise, is it's been around for so long. Like, my nephews and nieces know about Power Rangers. Like, that's cool to me. I'm gonna go watch it. I might make a movie, bro. Like, you know what? I'm gonna tell you what I'm gonna start doing. When this podcast gets really big enough, I'm gonna make an event called Theater with Me, or JT's Movie. And that's gonna be one where I'm gonna take people who are listening to my podcast, and we're gonna have I'm gonna pay for a free ticket for us to all go to the theaters and go watch a movie together, or just some type of movie event where I'm involved, or some type of screening event. Like, you know, I went to the Tower Theater. I went to the Tower Theater last week to go see Birth of a Nation, and it was just such a cool experience, man. Like, I love going to the movies, man. Shout out to the creator of movies. You know, shout out to the creator of movies. I love going to the movies. And I guess more since I've been alone more often now these last couple of months, I've been enjoying going to the movies a lot more. Like, I haven't went to the movies with no, check that back. My aunt took me to the movies, but I've been enjoying going to the movies with myself a lot more often, so it's kind of like a cool experience. But I think the reason why I like going to the movies is because, I don't know, it's a different experience for me, man. Like, you get to go to the movies, you get to sit down, you get your popcorn, you get your drink, you have a good time, and you just enjoy yourself. Like, it's a very, very cool experience, man. I just love it. Like, it's very, very, I just let it experience, man. You know, it's Thursday. I'm gonna be honest with you. This is what I'm probably gonna do. Probably tomorrow, I'm just gonna come out. I'm gonna do four podcasts tomorrow. Do four podcasts, probably three or four YouTube videos. And Thursday, I'm just gonna go to the movies all day. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go and just get a day where I can. Let me see how much that actually cost. Cause I want to do that. I really want to go and just. Okay, Power Rangers movie trailer. Here we go. Lionsgate Movies, produced by Lionsgate. It's amazing Lionsgate makes great movies but terrible phones.
Does that remind me of my screw up?
Watching the Power Rangers trailer with me right now.
No, I don't think we're ever going to understand each other. They got to come here every Saturday just to graduate with all these other weirdos and criminals.
I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my
So, this is where you come every Saturday instead of practice. Tragic.
Fat bitch.
I keep the ends out for the tie that binds.
Hey! It's a restricted area!
Guys?
There's something in there.
Somebody should have
pointed that out. Wait, I did.
This looks cool, bro. I ain't gonna lie to you. This looks actually pretty cool. Okay, this is going to be pretty cool. This is going to be pretty cool. You know, I'm going to see if I can find the first episode of Power Rangers ever and see if I can find it. Actually, it would be cool. I've... Go, go, Power Rangers! I don't remember if in the first one it automatically has super strength or super speed as this one is showing. But, you know, if they did, that's cool. I like it. I thought it was pretty tight. I like the trailer. I think it was pretty cool. Movies just keep getting better and better, man. I know that Justice League movie that they're coming out with, I know for a fact that that's going to suck, and I'm sad about that. But at the same time, I've told you before 1,000 times. I'm okay with the fact and understanding that DC Comics just does not produce good films, and it's okay. We all have talents where we do best at. I make great cookies. They make terrible films. They make great animated films. Like, let me not just write them off totally. They make very, very great animated films. Very great animated films. I'm gonna start talking like this. They make very, very great animated films. Very, very great animated films. But a lot of the time, their films just fall short of the mark of where they're trying to hit. And that's why I come in at the process. You know, I think they make very great animated films, but as far as regular films, their films are very, very, very tired as an old man's ass. You know, that's one point in the podcast that I really can't wait till I get to. I can't wait till I get to that point in the podcast where, you know, I'm promoting I can't wait to get to a point in the podcast where I have like movie promotions on the podcast, where I have movie people actually paying me to promote their movies, like paying the ad roles. Because if you don't know about podcasts, it's almost in a lot of ways like television, where the bigger your audience, the more they have to pay to have an ad role on your podcast, to have an advertisement. Like, say, for example, if when I have 13 million listeners, which I'm aiming for, I'm going to have to charge at least about $100,000 for a Disney, for a Pixar, for any other type of industry to have a role on my podcast. So you know, that'd be cool. You know, it's into, ooh, is that a woman? That sounds, that, I'm sorry I said that. That's just terrible. But you know, so you have to that's actually going to be something that's really cool, I guess, but I'm waiting to see for that to happen. Hopefully, that's the point I want to get to. Like, you know, it's kind of hard for me sometimes because I want to be in this industry and I want to make it and I want to be a part of the industry. But at the same time, I'm also fighting a war in that lane where you have to build a world for yourself. And I feel like Disney, Pixar, a lot of these older audience, these lot of older corporations in the entertainment industry, they are not so accepting of people like me, you know, like people like me who came up from the ground up, who didn't graduate college, who built their industry and built their following from the ground up through hard work. You know, they want people who have degrees. They want people who are qualified. They want people who are already in this. You know, I have one friend, actually, who, shout out to my friend, what was her name? What's her name? I know her name. I'm trying to remember, it was like a boyish name. Well, she works in film, and she actually ended up, she graduated ASU as a film something major director, something like that, and she, oh, shoot! Dude, okay, I just passed a trailer with the picture of the Power Ranger suits, dude, they look so raw. Oh my god. Oh my god, that's so cool. Oh my god. You know what? I see how people have, you know, it's funny seeing how people have these videos where just somebody's reaction to something. And it's actually pretty cool. But man, that's so raw. Oh my god, man. My imagination is just stirred right now. I'm not gonna lie to you. I'm my career, like right now, I'm gonna be honest with you when I'm talking to you. my creativity right now is just at an all-time high, and I feel really inspired right now just to go out in this world and create dope stuff, you know, even with the podcast, even with my music, even with my songwriting. Like, I want to put myself out there, and I just know I'm destined for greatness. I just know I got to keep fighting. I got to keep pushing forward. I got to start showing them that I'm the best. I got to start showing people that JT is a movement. And thank you, because it's people like you who have been supporting me, who have been supporting me through this whole process, and who are helping me get up to the top. And I really appreciate that. More than anything else in the world. If, like, you know, makes me feel, like I always say, it makes me feel good to get on this podcast. I know people really mess with my movement. You know, people really are vibing with me. People are feeling with me. And I love that sensation. I love the sensation of knowing that. I don't know. You know, coming back to my music, man, I'm thinking about getting back into that. See, the thing about what music to me is, it ain't so much about I like making music. I like making particular types of music. Like, I like samba. I like those Disney type of songs. Like, I like stuff like that. I don't want to make hip-hop. I love hip-hop, but I don't want to make it. I love hip-hop. I love all types of stuff. I just love stuff. So, I don't know. So we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Life goes on, man. Just life goes on. I don't know. We'll see, man. I'm always gonna keep the podcast thing, though. Definitely, I enjoyed the hell out of this. You know, just wish I had more people. I wish I had more people listening to me and telling me how I feel, because I feel like I feel like when people don't respond to me, I feel like I'm not producing at the quality that I should produce. And I was on a god dang chorus lane, you know. So it's nothing. But yeah, man, it's a lot to talk about. I don't know, I'm thinking about doing 3 episodes a day, bro. I'm not gonna lie to you. Cause sometimes I feel 3. Sometimes I feel 2 hours of audio a day ain't enough. I feel like I should do 3. I don't know. You tell me. Let me know. Do you think I should do 3? Are you ready to listen to me for 3 hours a day? You know, that's the amazing thing about doing podcasts, too. I always know what it's like. It's cool to really know that. It's amazing to think there's a lot of podcasts that I like. You know, I'm not going to give all their names out because some of them ain't been hitting me back for interviews. But it's crazy, man, because it's crazy to think I enjoy listening to people talk for 2 hours. Like, that's amazing to me. And I wonder if there's some... And I'm also looking at musical podcasts, now that I think about it. I see people who do, like, music podcasts. That's cool, too. You must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. You must learn to join the dance. I'm gonna stop. Okay. Well, people, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys know. This is it. But thank you for listening to the late night episode of the podcast. This has been your boy, JT. Make sure you tune in tomorrow at 1 p.m. Pacific time, or 13 hours Pacific time, whichever clock system you go by. It's been a pleasure talking to you. Been cool to get on the podcast. So there's people out there listening to me and vibe with me. Thank you so much for tuning in to me, boy.